In a bid to revitalize Uganda's manufacturing sector, the government is set to inject additional funds into the Mbale Industrial Park. Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa made this announcement on Friday during a walking tour at the Sino Uganda Mbale Industrial Park in eastern Uganda. Tayebwa was the official guest at the first phase of steel rolling trial production and second phase production groundbreaking ceremony of Unisteel, one of the factories in the industrial park. Mbale Industrial Park is one of the 22 state-level industrial parks promoted by President Yoweri Museveni to boost value addition and manufacturing. Spanning 2.51 square kilometers in Mbale City, the park is home to several manufacturing plants, including Unisteel, Uganda's largest steel plant. Addressing staff and guests at the event, Tayebwa emphasized that this investment is part of a broader package of incentives designed to transform the industrial hub.
Government of Uganda is going to invest 400 billion Uganda shillings in transforming this industrial park. We have already signed the contract with China Railway number 3, and they are performing. We might have challenges, Mr. Zhang, of delayed payments, but government is government.
The Uganda National Examination Board, UNEP, has registered a total of 2,905 candidates to sit for the Uganda Certificate of Education, UCE, under the new lower secondary curriculum, whereas 50 are going to take transition exams in Busia District. Aloro Tapa, the Busia UNEP supervisor, cited an increase of 24 candidates this year compared to 2,881 candidates who sat for the UCE in 2023. He attributed the increase to routine public sensitization by stakeholders on the significance of education.
I want the students to be at school, and I convince very well the students the value of education. Because minus education, you can't fit anywhere.
This year we have about 50 in the whole district of Busia. We have 50 candidates who are going to seek this transitional examination. And then when it comes to the new lower secondary curriculum, we have 2,905 candidates registered for this examination for new curriculum.
As Yepet Helen Barbara, the head teacher of Tira Secondary School, located in the gold mining area, is optimistic about better performance under the new lower secondary curriculum because they took advantage of the gold mining sites in the area to offer practical learning for candidates.
This new curriculum is very practical. When they tell you we are learning about minerals, we just take our learners in the processing areas, we give them practical knowledge on how the processing of minerals, for example, gold, and what exactly do we mean by gold, how do we get it? It has been an advantage on our side.
While speaking to some of the candidates, they expressed readiness for the unprecedented exams.
Personally, I'm happy that I'm going to sit my exams this year. You see, in this new curriculum, we've taken 5 years so far, so I'm very confident that I'm going to pass.
For me, I'm so prepared and very ready for the exams because we have been prepared by our powerful teachers.
An extra 600 Kenyan police officers said to join a UN-backed mission to try to quell rampant gang violence in Haiti will be ready for deployment in early November, according to Kenya's police chief. President William Ruto had on Friday pledged the additional officers following a meeting with Haiti's interim Prime Minister Garry Conille as the two leaders appealed for the international community to do more.
I am pleased to announce that an additional 600 Kenyan police officers are completing their pre-deployment training and will be ready for duty next month. Our officers are working closely with the Haitian National Police to restore order, structure, and create safe spaces where Haitians can thrive.
The East African country is leading the multinational mission aimed at tackling spiraling insecurity in the crime-ravaged Caribbean nation and has so far sent 400 police. On Friday, Ruto had urged the international community to urgently rally behind the mission, which has been hobbled by a chronic lack of funding.
Kenya and Haiti, therefore, stand united in calling on the international community to urgently rally behind this mission.
The progress that we're seeing is contingent on us continuing to provide the Haitian people with the relief that is desperately needed. And of course, that will only happen if the many commitments that were made by the international community actually materialized.
The Haitian leader's visit to Kenya comes a week after gang members opened fire in the Haitian town of Pont de Sonde, some 100 kilometers from the capital Port-au-Prince, butchering 109 people and wounding around 40 more.